press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
तो मेरे तो नहीं है
take a value, suppose 100 by 10 is there, 100 by 10 is nothing but what? 10 into 1. That is actually what you have taken. I will get 1 into 2. Here you have taken is R into 1. You are looking for transformation only. Now from this transformation, take T1 by Vs equal to what? 1 by Ts. And from this Ts equal to what? T1 into Ts. And V2 by Vr is 1 by Tr. From this we are getting Vr equal to V2 into Tr. Yesterday whenever we are seeing the series capacitor compensation, we are using one equation. Vs minus Vr equal to 1. Ir cos phi r plus Ixl into sin phi r. Same equation I am using. In this the component of I cos phi r in terms of actual power T by Vr, I sin phi r Q by Tr. So it is nothing but P equal to 1. P equal to Vi sin cos phi. V equal to what? Vi sin. So substitute these values of in this equation, we are getting this equation cross multiplying, and finally we are getting this equation. In this equation, we are substituting the values of what? Vr and Vs values. You can observe in this equation. In this equation, V1 is 225 is coming from other substation or generating station, so that T1 is a constant. And resistance and inductance of the transmission line for a constructed line, it is a constant. Now the load requirement of P and Q is also a constant. So which is a variable? Tr and Ts is variable. Okay, so V2 is a function of what? Tr and Ts. So by controlling of this V2, which one has to be controlled? Tr and Ts, Ts are number of tasks, positions have to be. Here, the product of Tr and Ts is what is better than half nominal ratio or fitting. This value is normally taken as what? 1. So, examination problem point of view, if you are not given the half nominal fitting value, you can take it as 1. If you are given any value, then you can use that particular value. Is okay? Right. Now, in this one particular point, you have to remember is whenever you give the dance, tasks must be always provided on the high position. Because whenever actually if you think of the tasks, actually I have given a number like this 1, 2, 3, just I am giving some number of tasks like this. Okay. Now you can assume that initially the switch is at the task number 1. Now the task whenever actually want to control the voltage, I have to change the task. When it is actually changing to 1 to 2, during this transition, there existed some arcing will be put. Here, the intensity of the arc is depending on the current which is actually flowing on this particular side. So, and actually if the current is more, arcing will also be more. When arcing is more, heating is more, that will damage the insulation, everything, internal to the transformer. So that we have to reduce this intensity of arc. It is entirely depending on current. So, if you take a transformer on this side, the current is less. H is L is H is the current is yes. So for that reason, transformer taps are always provided on this side, H is L. Don't say primary. It should be on, primary may be LV also. Okay. So you should always remember it. Taps are provided on this one, H is L. Here. Now here, this OLTC operation is most widely used in our power system network in all the substations areas. But it is not used in our distribution system. Because they will take 11 kV by 400 volts. Because actually the transformer taps you want to change means the transformer should be in substation. Okay, suppose up to 33 by 11 kV, these transformers are normally in the substations. So that actually there someone will be there and they will operate and they will change the, they will measure the voltage levels and they can operate and they will maintain the voltage. But in case of distribution transformers of 11 kV by 400 volts, so many distribution transformers will sustain such a thing. No one will be there to monitor what is the voltage, what is the top position. Very difficult. But the distribution transformers, normally they will provide the tap. Up to 33 by 11 kV, normally we are using the tap. And 33 by 11, 132 by 33, 220 by 132, 400 by 220, like this also they can use the OLTC taps are used. But these taps in India exclusively, we are not using on the generating transformers. The reason is, whenever actually generating transformers wind up, we are using step up, right? we are going to release from 15 kV to 220 kV, they are coming out. So whenever actually generator is connected on one side of the transformer, LV side of the transformer, HV side is connected to the bus bar. The bus bar actually connected to the transmission line. Right. So whenever actually on HV side the taps are changing, taps are actually is a mechanical device. Whenever changing the tap number 1 to tap number 2 means it is a mechanical switching operation. It is not electronic. Okay, it is actually changing from 1 to 2, 2 to 3 like this. This mechanical switching may produce some obstruction. So somewhere it will actually block it. By doing transition from 1 to 2, it is blocked off. Then what is actually power transfer from primary to second? Completely disturbed. So that will actually cause interruption for the power generation. For this purpose, India actually will not prefer the tap changing at the generating stations. Generating station transformers, they are not providing the thing. They are providing the option, but practically they will not use. Okay. So actually, we come to the voltage control part. We have seen the shunt capacitor. Shunt capacitor, shunt reactor and all this. So the most widely we are using is of on distribution study, the transmission part and substation part. You can use shunt capacitor first reactor here. And if the shunt capacitor is not able to get sufficient amount of voltage level, then we can go for OLTC operation. Because actually the life of the transformer is more important. Suppose you take one particular area, where actually the transformers are actually kept. In that area, if the number of tap operations are very high, morning 10, evening 10, afternoon 10, random you can use chain, automatically the taps and everything will get damaged. The number of tap operations must be minimized. But the problem, whenever actually you are getting a problem with the transformer is, if any problem occurs with the transformer, for replacement of the transformer will take more time. It is actually not a single unit. You are having so many bulk units of winding and internal, actually radiators, cooling mechanism, everything having bulk size. To remove that much of bulk size and replace the new one, it will take minimum of 15 to 1 month, 15 days to 1 month it will take. Okay, so that will, up to that time, complete interruption is there for the public. So for that actually what they prefer basically is, first you can operate the shunt capacitor. Right, with that, if you manage the voltage, fine. If it's not possible, then go for this one, OLTC operation. Right, okay. Here some shunt reactor point of view, at low voltage levels, for example, up to 220 kV levels, you are not using the shunt reactor. Here the substation. Can you practically in India, we are not using shunt reactors up to what? 220 kV levels. But the shunt reactors are used for 400 kV and 760 kV levels. Suppose you take one 400 kV transmission line is there. It is going from Lucknow to Delhi. Clear. Lucknow is actually the generating station is kept. They are actually stuck up. The voltage is up to 400 kV and they are transferring up to the Delhi. So here, the Delhi substation, we are expecting that same 400 kV has to be transferred. But during night time or during low load conditions, the voltage will be boosted. 450 to 500. So that excess voltage will also cause us changes in the all the 220 kV, 130 kV levels. So, in case of one, that will actually produce damage to the insulation. So because of these reasons, actually, on 400 kV substation, they can provide with a shunt reactor. They will try to reduce the extra current here. They will give a compensating that, they can provide with the shunt reactor. Similarly for 760 kV. And so after 220 kV level, they will not use any shunt reactor. Okay? Clear. But this is actually most practically used for voltage control. Note to the point. OLTC. OLTC. Is the most practical method for the voltage control for the voltage control. It is used in the all voltage levels. It is used in the all voltage levels. Except in distribution system. Except in distribution system. In brackets 11 kV by 400 volts. 11 kV by 400 volts. Okay. And in the generating station and in the generating station power transformers. Generating station power transformers and in the generating station power transformers. Next one. The tanks are provided. Taps are provided on the high voltage side. On the high voltage side of the power transformer. Because the intensity of arcing is less due to current is small in HV side. Now coming to the booster transformer. Then listen here. For example, for example, if you think of one traction line, you want to travel from Delhi to Agra, your girlfriend. Okay. So this is a traction line. As this traction line, what you can expect that for the complete length of the line, we have to expect the same voltage or different voltage?
Same
voltage. Then only there is no disturbance. Right? For the time. Okay. Now here, this actually what you are getting is, but actually the material what actually are using in the traction line, it is having some higher drop. Resistance is there, so that you are having some voltage drop is there. This is what called higher drop. Because of the voltage drop, sometimes the voltage is minimum, the train may halt. Okay, get disturbance, sufficient voltage you cannot able to get for the train. So for maintaining uniform voltage throughout the traction line, wherever the voltage is actually dropping, that voltage we have to push. So for those applications, can be the what? Push the transformer. Yes, okay. So the main thing is actually, simple way is, up to now what we have discussed, shunt capacitor, shunt reactor, series capacitor, all this actually we are concentrating only for the distribution end, consumer end. We are receiving end voltage, how to maintain constant. Okay, now this is actually used for maintaining uniform voltage throughout the transmission line. That is the basic difference between the remaining one and this. Got a point, right? So for this booster transformer, they will take from the source side only. For the booster transformer, the supply is given from the source side only. They are providing the taps. So if I change the tap position, the voltage will be changed. Automatically will boost the voltage of the line. Right?
Thank you.
Is passing, it produces magnetic flux. So this magnetic flux, whenever this turbine is rotating, will actually, this flux will be cut the stator, and this stator will actually produce some actually EMF. This is what we call it as a generated voltage. Right, okay. So this generated voltage, we are supposed to maintain a constant value. So this is a comparator. And we are actually maintaining this what is compared to some reference voltage. For example, we have to maintain the reference voltage is actually 10. That means generated voltage also you have to maintain the value is how much?
10.
Whenever both are equal, what is error you will get? 0. Actually, the error voltage is difference, Vg minus Vf. So whenever it is 0, then the current injecting inside to the rotor is a constant. This is what is called constant excitation. That is the first case. Vg equal to V reference, Ve equal to 0. So we are having constant excitation means current injection is constant. Suppose the current is actually Vg is increased to 12, assume that. But actually V reference is 10. What is the error? That is becoming 2. So error is becoming 2 positive. When it is positive means this is more voltage. You have to reduce. What do you have to do that now? Reduce the excitation. The reduction in the excitation is normally you will do by using
alpha increase for the reduce.
Actually higher under this condition F is becoming positive. We have to reduce this error or this reduction of the error. What we can do is actually we have to reduce this excitation. It is actually done by changing the firing angle of this rectifier. Now we are using SCR, the firing angle has to be changed. But changing this actually can change this current injection value so that until this 12 is becoming 10. When this 12 is becoming 10, the error is becoming what? Whenever this error is becoming 0, then actually you are maintaining the constant excitation. The third case, suppose Vg value is becoming 9. If value is 9, then actually what is the error?
Nine.
Minus. So our balance one, have increased it. So that this angle is becoming 9 is becoming 10 and the other is becoming what? This process is actually we are done. I mean not by manually, it is done automatically. It is going to call this automatic voltage regulation. Here, olden days we already studied in electrical machines. In olden days actually the type of the excitation we are giving is brush excitation. We are using separate DC system. From the DC system we are actually injecting the current inside of this particular main rotor. But actually nowadays we are not using brush, we are using brushless excitation. So that is actually what we are using and technically call it as a pilot excitation. So this is actually a turbine. The turbine is coupled to a, this is actually shaft is the, and for the shaft what you are having is the, this for the same shaft is actually extended up to the rectifier and pilot excitation. Okay. So whenever actually you are giving a, when the rotor is, turbine is rotating, if this rotor is rotating, rectifier is also rotating, this pilot excitator is also rotating. The pilot excitator is actually consisting of, this is actually pilot excitator, this is actually the connection extension here. It is actually containing a permanent magnet. This is a permanent magnet. So this permanent magnet, whenever it is rotating, it is actually rotating. So what will happen? It will produce a flux. Flux will be at the center of the pilot excitator. Then it will induce an EMF. So that EMF is given by VAC. This VAC is actually rectified. It is actually producing a DC voltage. Right. Now this DC voltage is actually injecting the current of what? So that is how actually we are practically doing in such a okay. And we are injecting and we are maintaining the constant. Right? Here, just note on point here. Current and injecting the DC current. So these rotor coils, and this magnitude of DC current, and this magnitude of DC current, is controlled by controlling the DC excitation, sorry, controlling firing angle of the silicon control expert. Firing angle of the SCR. Simply we will put SCR. Next one. The current injection is depending on error produced. Error produced at the output of the comparator. Okay, next one. This is the last method. This is the final method. You can put final method. Adapt it. Adapt it after offering. After applying other methods like shunt capacitor, OLTC. Operation, etc.
Hare Hare, what do you say about it?
I request don't hit. Okay. Right, okay. This is actually you have covered. And physically how it looks like, just to show you some of the photos and part of some videos also. Okay, just can observe here. One by one, this will discuss. See here, this is actually, everyone knows this concept. This is actually the power generating station, this is a power plant. So from the power plant, actually you are producing the electrical power. And by using this step-up transformers, and you are actually the electrical power is transferred to the transmission line. And actually using a step-down transformer, and finally you are distributing to the local distribution area networks. Okay, this is actually to the consumer. Right. This is actually basic power system network. In this, if you see actually how these generating stations and substations of different ratings are practically connected. So how many of you from Bhopal? Madhubri. Okay, right. Can I guess? Because actually in the internet actually for the Bhopal State Electricity Department. In grid map is actually they have given in detail compared to the other states. I have collected that information in the last before year actually whenever I am taking class at Bhopal. Okay, so I will show you that layout. I will explain each one. But you will understand. Suppose as per your state is concerned, some of the grid maps are available in the net. You can go through, once you understood one grid map of any state, you can easily understand for the other states also. So what India network also can able to easily analyze. They're okay, right? This will take the Madhya Pradesh State Electricity Board, actually how it the grid map is looks like. This is actually the state of the Madhya Pradesh. In this actually how the all the lines and all are interconnected together. Okay. So it's not clear, this I will expand then one by one. Okay, now it is visible towards the back side, okay? Any problem? Alright. Now you can observe here, before analyzing any grid map, first you go through the lesson you should follow first. We give some notation, this is a lesson actually. This lesson you have to follow. So they will give what are the symbols that they can use for each line. For example, for 763 kV transmission line, in case of multiple rates, we have all the types of lines are there. 763 kV line is actually run by Power Grid Corporation, that is run by PGC here. It is actually, you will use the line, symbol is, it's like a blue line with some small squares in between. And this is for 400 kV transmission line with a red line. And this is 400 kV transmission line run by PGCL with circles, and for Madhya Pradesh State Electricity Board with a straight line. Okay, this is a 220 kV line with a green line, 130 kV line with some other color. This is 765 kV substation. Okay, this is actually 400 kV substation with red one. This is run by the 400 kV by MP LCD board. And this is a 220 kV substation. And this one is what? 132 kV substation. This is a thermal power station symbol. And this is the hydro power station symbol. Okay, so before starting any power grid map analysis, first go through this lesson. What is the symbol rotation they are using? This actually is completed project, already existing one. And this is what proposed one. Okay. Nowadays, actually, this is one of the old maps when some of the projects are already completed also. Okay. So, just you can go through this, I will explain this one map. You will get some idea. Just you can think of here. So this is actually the one of the largest power generating station in Madhya Pradesh. It is actually Vindhyachal thermal power station. It is having the total power capacity is around 4000 plus megawatts of power. Okay, it is one of the largest power generating station in India. And it is actually run by NTPC, National Thermal Power Corporation. And what is the power actually produced? That is actually when distributed, transmitted is actually done by power gain transmission. Or production is by NTPC, transmission by PGC. Yes. So this much of bulk amount of power of 4000 plus megawatts of power is actually transmitting through 8 transmission lines. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 lines. This is actually having 4 lines. Okay. So this power is actually, they are actually transferring to this first 4 lines. First we go through these 4 lines. What is the meaning of these 4 lines? How actually they will transfer? This actually arranged. Don't think that it is R, Y, B, N. Clear? Okay. So just I will show how actually they will indicate this one, same part. We will discuss all this one. So this is actually the transmission lines, how they will actually transfer. So this is actually one line, R, Y, B. This is one line on one side of the tower, and this is of R, Y, B. This is what? Other side of the tower. So these are two lines. Like that, you can imagine one more tower is there here, it will also carry two more lines. So what the total lines are? Four lines. Are you clear? Right. So each one having R by B and R by B. That is actually how to think of. Right. Now, just see that here. So you are having this, what are the tower actually I have shown here? This tower is what people call as a double circuit line. Clear? This double circuit means is one circuit R by B. This one is another circuit R by B. Clear? Okay. So that is actually called as double circuit line. Right. So in this double circuit line, there is these two are one double circuit line, these two are another double circuit line. They are transferring this power from Vindhyachal. This area is what called Vindhyachal thermal station. I can go through these four lines first. So from Vindhyachal station, first it will go to the one of the generating substation, is what called Satna Power Grid Corporation. So this is a red one indicates 400 kV line. Already you have seen that this is a 400 kV line. So this 400 kV line now actually stepped down to 220 kV line. Green one indicates what? 220 kV line. So this 220 kV line from this 400 kV substation, they are sending to another 220 kV substation. Yes. So from this 220 kV substation, they are stepped down to 132 kV. Clear? This is the color indicates what? 132 kV. So they are stepped down to 132 kV. This 132 kV, actually they are sending to different areas from this one. Right? Okay. So now come to the one more. This 400 kV substation. These four lines are actually some power will be transmitted to all these substations. 220 kV, 132 like this. And some of the power will also flow these four lines. Just you can observe, these four lines will go to the Veena. Here, Veena substation. From this, it will go to the same Veena. This is actually run by PGCL. This is run by Madhya Pradesh State Electricity. Now, from this, actually, these four lines now actually splitting into two lines. These two lines, this is what? Another two lines. These are the another two lines. Now, these two lines. Through these two lines actually are sending the power up to the Bhopal. Here, from the Bhopal, actually these two lines actually expand everywhere, it will step down to 220 kV, 220 to 132 kV like this. So some of the power will be now, it will pass through this one, through the Bhopal to Itarsi. Right, okay. So from this Itarsi generating station, then sorry, substation, now actually it is going to the what? Here, from the Jabalpur, now you can observe here, now these are the four lines which are actually connected to the what? One secondary. Are you clear? So, this is a closed loop system. This is what called as ring distribution system. Okay, just I will repeat. Start that Vindhyachal, it will go to the first to Satna, Satna to, it will go to the Veena. Veena to, it will go to the Bhopal, Bhopal to Itarsi, Itarsi to Jabalpur, Jabalpur to actually going to the
Vindhyachal.
So negative is the sign, look at the idea now. Just see that, these right is the path. If you complete one, you will go like this, this is the path. Is it okay? This one is what? Source 1 is what we have done. Ring distribution or ring distribution. Right. Okay. Now, just we have seen that one generating station like India Jal. Along with this, we take other generating stations also. This is actually one of the generating stations, Birsingpur main generating station. So in the Birsingpur, this is a thermal station. This is not Birsingpur, right, the hydro station. Now this hydro station and generating thermal station here. This is a hydro station where the power is produced. It is actually they are sending to the 220 kV substation. And this thermal station is also sending to the what? This 220 kV substation. Like this, one generating station is actually interlinked with the other generating station. Got the idea? Clear. Now this 220 kV, whatever this thermal station is there, there actually the 400 kV lines are there. Now this 400 kV is connected. Now this 400 kV is once again is connected to the another 220 kV line. So like all this are interlinked. These 120 kV somewhere it should be interconnected with the other station. For example, in America, from Katni to it is getting Kaimur, Kaimur to Satna. Satna is once again connected to what? Satna station. This is actually interlinked with the which one? Clear? Okay. So if one of the stations supply is failed, then other from the other station is unable to take the power. Right? Okay. Like this, actually, all the generating stations, so many is actually one double station. Okay. We are having one more hydro stations are there. All these hydro stations, if you go through the each one, all are interconnected with one with the other one. This is what completely what for the grid system. Clear? Okay. Right, practically normally what you think, grid is nothing but a closed loop. From this all the generating stations are connected on one side, distribution is connected on the other side. That is not the practical case. Practical case, this is actually the practical case, how all the stations are interconnected through the our complete main substation. You got some idea, you know, actually physically it will look like. So, this is actually one more interconnected state, which means from one state to the other state also, it is actually interconnected. For example, just show here. Just here. This is actually Madhya Pradesh. Now, Madhya Pradesh is connected to? These are 765 kV line, actually, you are having this line is there. From Gwalior, Gwalior to is connected to what? So, not only this 765. And 220 kV lines also actually they are having connection. Just see that. So, Madhya Pradesh, they are having one area of Ujjain. These are 220 kV lines. This 220 kV line is connected to what? What are related to? So, from one state to other state also, they are having interconnection is there from the main to the transmission line. Here, one substate to other one. So, depending on the requirement, suppose actually we have studied. Means last year, when normally northern grid fail disaster. Okay, center condition, suppose if one state power failure is there, we have to get the power from other states also. Clear? For that reason, actually, they are having some interconnect is there from one state to the other state. Suppose one state having surplus amount of power is there, they will sell the power to the other state, which is actually having less amount of power. For that reason, all is actually connected. So, like this, throughout India, you can see, throughout India, all the generating stations and substations are actually connected together. That is actually, not, this actually not here. Okay. So, means, whatever actually are given, that means actually, in the next class, I will show you that Indian grid map also, how all the states and how the, all the main generating stations are interconnected throughout the country. From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, actually complete one interconnection is there. In one state. But whatever you have seen already in the Madhya Pradesh, it is connected to Rajasthan, and it is connected to other states like UP, like that, all the generating stations and substations are transmission lines are interconnected. Right? Okay. Clear. With this one, we will see the transmission line part. Now, presently, as per our topic, can think like so. Yes, yes. This is actually the topic we have already discussed. This one is what? Compensators or shunt capacitors. So this is actually the practical arrangement of compensators in the substation. Here, complete one, but the compensators are available. Different substation areas actually provided. This is actually for different phases or winding phases how the capacitors are physically looks like. Right? So this is actually the suppose you think of these R phase, Y phase and B phase. So as yesterday I have drawn one diagram. So when the bus bar, the capacitor bank is connected. Clear, okay. That is actually, this is actually the arrangement. This is actually one set for R phase, three for Y phase, these are what? This is a closer view, this is the capacitor bank. Each one is called as cell. This is actually one CS, you have given CS actually, CS equal to C phase. Right, each one is called as a cell. This one is called as a cell. Okay. Okay. This is actually each one called as a cell. Now this is a cell is looks like. This is actually each cell is looks like capacitor cell. And what are the ratings? They given the each ratings are already given. So it is actually 37.8 amps. And it is having a capacitance of 10.96 microfarad. This is what capacitance of each cell and each cell is how it looks like. Okay. Now this one is mean another way of arranging the same capacitor bank. This is one arrangement. This is actually one arrangement. Capacitor bank. This is actually having another arrangement. So you can see that the R phase is what? Y phase is actually what? This is actually complete one is called as capacitor bank. Right? Group of capacitors. Right. This one is what called as a shunt reactor. This is a shunt reactor. Normally you can prefer in case of 400 kV and 765 kV substation. This is actually the shunt reactor. Nothing but a simple inductor. This is one type of the shunt reactor. This is what you are having. Other type of shunt reactor. Right? This one is a series capacitor. This actually is not related to Indian conditions. Actually related to Norway. Okay, they are using the series capacitors. Yesterday we have discussed how the series capacitor is actually connected. This is a transmission line. This is a series capacitor. This is output. So, for different phases, R, Y and B phase. Now actually the series capacitor will look like practical. Right? Okay. This is related to the travelling wave and the time to discuss all this. Okay. These are actually the topics. What we have seen. Got some idea. Right? Right. So, we will continue with the topic. Next one.
Switch on the lights,
please. Good job. Good job. Show that up. Show
generator Yeah, assume that we get six. Because the remote is paid. Okay. So what is actually 15 kV by 220 kV? Transformer. And you are forming a 220 kV bus bar. Right? I'll take some practical examples. Assume that this generator is actually situated at Delhi. 100 MVA capacity. Now this 100 MVA is actually you are transferring the power to the transformer of 100 MVA transformer, and this 100 MVA power, some part of the power to a transmission line of 50 MVA capacity, 50 MVA of power is actually transferred to the one of the area in the from Delhi to assume that Noida. What is the remaining now? Out of 100, what remaining?
50.
So the remaining 50 is actually a step down by using here, you can think of here, this is actually 150 MVA transformer of 220 by 132 kV capacity. Here, now this 50 MVA, now they are forming 132 kV bus bar. Right, so this 50 plus 50 will get total 100 MVA. Now this 50 MVA, now actually they are forming 100 kV bus bar, and from this you can think of it is actually distributed to two transformers, each one having 132 by 33 kV, and he is actually having one more transformer of 30 MVA, one is 20 MVA, another is 30 MVA, he is also 132 by 33 kV. Now, and this actually I am taking 30 and 20, no problem. This is actually 30 MVA, this one is 20 MVA I am taking. This 30 MVA, it is actually supplied to the our metro application, traction application. Now, this 20 MVA, now it is there forming a 133 kV bus bar. Okay. Now this 30 kV bus, from this they are using transformers here. Each one can think of is actually 10 MVA transformer of 33 by 11 kV. It is of what? Another 10 MVA transformer of same rating of voltage. Now these actually they are forming from 11 kV bus bar, and this 11 kV distributed to the different areas. So here this 10 MVA, assume that they are supplying to one of the area called as Sahid. So this 11 kV out of this 10 MVA is there. This 10 MVA now actually by using the 11 kV by 400 volts, and this is also same thing, 11 kV by 400 volts of this I am taking 5 MVA transformer, 3 MVA transformer and 2 MVA transformer. So this is actually going to different areas. For example, it is going to the one of the areas where it has Radu Sarai. It is going to the Kalu Sarai. Okay. So this is how actually the complete process actually we are doing. The from the generating station up to the what? Here. Now here our target is, suppose we are supposed to maintain this 33 kV voltage level constant. Here. For maintaining this 33 kV voltage level, what we can do is, in this substation where the bus bars are kept in the substations only, not on the roadside. Okay. So in this substation, 30 kV bus bar is located. Now we are using one capacitor bank. That is what I have shown just now. This is actually one capacitor bank, and I am showing the two capacitor banks in this case, capacitor bank 1 and capacitor bank 2. Capacitor bank 1 and 2 with some control breakers are provided. For maintaining this 130 kV, you can think that they are providing with one more capacitor bank. these actually are in the bank for this. The balance bank number 3 is something here. And for the 220 kV side, bus bar, they will not provide any capacitor bank. Okay, up to 130 kV level only, presently we are using these capacitor banks are used. Right? And here, for maintaining this voltage level of this one, that MEA capacity here, for this actually you can use a what? One is what you get? OLTC can be used here. Here also you can use OLTC. Here also they can use OLTC. Right, but they will not use the OLTC in the generating transformer. Right, okay. So what is the operation, how actually they will do is, suppose you want to maintain 33 kV. Instead of 33 kV, in afternoon time the voltage is coming only 28 kV. But it's 28 kV, what is the first step they will do is, first they will operate the this capacitor bank. Here, capacitor bank either of one, either maybe one or two, they can operate. First close of this, one of the capacitor bank either one or two, and check the voltage, observe the voltage. Whether you are getting 28 to getting 33 or not. Suppose they are getting only 28 to 29 or 30. For the next option is, they will switch on the second capacitor bank. Now observe it. If it is 33, fine, stop the operation. They are only getting 31. Instead of getting 31, then what they will do is, they will go for the OLTC of this transformer nearby. So with this, you are getting 33, okay. Otherwise, they will actually observe the primary side voltage. If it is 132, you will get 133. Suppose instead of 132, incoming voltage itself is getting 128 kV. Then immediately what they will do is, they will do the operation of this capacitor bank in actually charge. So that the voltage will be, when the voltage will be boosted 132 kV, fine. If it is not increased to 132, it is coming only 130 only after switching on the capacitor bank, then they will operate the this voltage. You are okay. So they will not operate the voltage is if it is 132, fine. Otherwise, what they will do is they will observe the 220 kV supply. 220 kV side, instead of 220 you are going only 210 or 200 kV is there. Immediately they will make a call to the generating station, please change your excitation. Clear, okay. So now they will change the excitation because 220 kV is increased, 130 kV is increased, finally you are able to maintain which one? 33 kV. Suppose the 11 kV voltage you have to maintain, then they will not use on the 11 kV side, they will not use capacitor band. The only option you are having is what? OLTC has to be operated for this case. Here, whether for voltage rise or voltage fall, this is sequence you have to follow. Don't think that for voltage actually low value, you have to boost from the voltage from 28 to 33 kV. You are going like this. For whenever the voltage is becoming 33 to 37, you are not going like this. You have to start from the capacitor bank. You are okay. Suppose voltage is higher, 33 to 33, increase 35, 36 is there. First step is switch off the capacitor bank. Then go for OLTC. Then capacitor bank. Then OLTC. Finally go for the exertion. Okay, this is the sequence actually you have to follow for the voltage. So what the sequence is? First you can sequence for voltage control. Capacitor bank. Next one. OLTC. Last one is Right. So with this we have completed voltage relaxed power or power factor compensation. Now we'll start with the other topic. Not power flow through transmission line. Power flow through transmission line. Topic, what actually the main concepts we are concentrating are, one by one, there are four subtopics are there in this one. First one is, so this is a generator. The generator is delivering both the active and reactive power or the operant power to the unit. And you are receiving this all the parameters like operant power, active and reactive power. So these parameters of sending end powers as well as receiving end powers are related on the receiving end voltage, sending end voltage and as well as the ABCD parameters of the transmission line. So what is the mathematical relation between the powers and the these all these ABCD parameters and voltages? That is first step actually what you are deriving on expression. You're okay, there one thing. And second one is, our ultimate goal is here, that's what I already told. Whenever actually I am using some compensation, like shunt capacitor, so that the reactive power which is actually produced or supplied by the generator, I can able to reduce, so that operant power is maximum I can able to convert into active power. Okay, so the generator is the only device which produces the active power. We have to receive maximum active power at the load end. Okay, and what condition of the load you can able to receive the maximum active power. That is about second part. Third one, what is the locus of the powers, sending and receiving end powers, if this Vs and Vr are maintained constant value. That is third one. And last one, the mathematical expression I given very first class, the actual PR is given by PSVR by XL into sin delta and QR is given by PSVR by XL into cos delta minus PR square by XL. So, okay, how you are getting those equations. Okay, so these topics actually we are covering in this question. So, what is the main objective of this particular topic? This is a very important topic. Concept point also and the practical point also. Suppose, see, up to now, we have discussed about the voltage control topic like shunt capacitor, shunt reactor, all this we have discussed. In these topics, we are always discussing about how much, what is the rating, how much is the reactive power it will supply, how to improve the power factor from 0.6 to 0.8 or 0.8 to some value, increasing. That part only we have discussed up to now. So in this topic actually, by injecting this much of reactive power, what is the change in the voltage? What is the advantage in the voltage that you are actually getting, that you are able to see in this topic? Are you understand? Clear? Not only power factor, along with this, what is the voltage you can able to boost or you are able to reduce by using a either a shunt capacitor or shunt reactor or synchronous phase modulator. Are you clear? Right. So first one here. What you are taking, but first actually we will derive the relation of the sending end powers and receiving end powers in terms of voltage and ABCD parameters. This derivation is important for your conventional process. Therefore, the IES conventional is derivation important. Simple one, this is the logic how to remember all this. So, just can copy and manually explain. And okay.
Generation of natural effective power generator. Mm. और ये फिर रिएक्टिव पावर भी कंसीडर होता है,
रिएक्टिव पावर भी जनरेट करता है जनरेटर।
सर अभी तो बोले कि जनरेटर फिर रिएक्टिव पावर जनरेट करता है,
उसके अंदर जो इंडक्टर जो लगा रहता है ट्रांसफार्मर के अंदर, मेजर पोर्शन जो है ना वो मतलब जनरेट करता है जो एक्टिव पावर होता है।
Thank you. I
How to remember this derivation, or give how to remember this simple way, how to complete derivation part. In observing here, the equation for the receiving end powers, P R and Q R, normally power equation actually given by P equal VA cos phi and Q is VA sin phi. But in this equation, there is no current term, I term is not there. You are all the parameters are expressed in what? Voltage parameter. So the only way you have to remember simple technique is whatever the current term is there, current term could also be expressed in voltage. That is the only part you have to remember. Here you can observe here. The sending end voltage Vs equal to AVR plus VAR. Now this IR, receiving end current, now it is expressed in terms of what? Voltage. So substitute all the parameters of the voltages, magnitude and angles, and get the conjugate, and this conjugate function is substituted in the equation of VR into IR conjugate. Separate the real term and remainder term. Real term is VR, remainder term is what? So remember one equation, all the remaining equations you can easily remember also. So VR is given by ESVR by B cos of beta minus delta minus AVR square by B cos of beta minus alpha. Right. Instead of cos, you can put sign, what you get? Right, P is for the receiving end powers. Similarly, for the sending end powers also you can observe, in this equation, there is no current term is not there, I term is not there, only having voltage term. For that, you can observe here, IS is given by CVR plus VIR. Here you are having voltage and current. This current is the first equation already expressed in voltage. Here, okay, so that value you can substitute here. And simplify, DC minus AD equal to minus 1 because of AD minus DC is 1. So that we can substitute, this is the value of IS, get the IS conjugate by taking magnitudes and angles. Simplify this one. This value of IS conjugate, now we are substituting in the this equation of sending end powers. Right. So separate the real and imaginary terms. The real term is PS, imaginary term is what? Any difficulty? Only thing is current to be expressed in what? Voltage. That is the only thing you have to remember. So I have written now. Because I have seen some of the students, they are meditating to some second time. Same part. Right. You remember this equation also very easily. For a symmetrical system, A equal to D. For a transmission line of symmetrical, A equal to what? D. For that, suppose it is in place of A, you can put D, is related to the receiving end, so that you are having VR. Here it is actually sending end, for that you have taken as what? VS. So, the same thing, this is actually AVR square by B, now it is becoming what? BVS square by B cos of beta minus of. This is becoming first term. This one is what? Second term. With plus VSVR by B cos of what? Beta plus. You're okay. But sign, what you get? This becoming? Right, okay. This is actually this derivation in auto. Remember, simple one. But for the conventional point of it is important. Right? Okay, next one, hold on. Condition for maximum. Active power transfer. Condition for maximum active power transfer. just clear here. So our ultimate goal is to receive maximum value of and our PR should be higher. What we require. So in this equation you can observe, for already constructed transmission line, VS, VR and D is a constant. V and V die related, so V die is also a constant. So alpha is related to A, it is also a constant. It is a variable. Delta is variable. So for receiving maximum PR, or PR max, what you can take to the derivative with respect to delta and equal to because of delta is variable. So if you do the derivative, what you get? This is actually given by Vs Vr by V sin of beta minus delta with minus equal to what? In these two terms, which is 0? Sin of beta minus delta, that is what you get? Delta is equal to 1. Delta minus beta or beta minus delta is 0. That means what the value of delta required? Delta is equal to because of delta is a variable quantity. Right. So, at delta equal to beta, what the value of PR, we are getting maximum value that you can substitute, is actually given by Vs PR by V minus AVR square by V into cos of beta minus alpha. So, this is the maximum active power that you can able to receive. If Q R is actually given Vs Vr by P into sin of beta minus delta minus A Vr square by P into sin of beta minus alpha. Okay. Now at delta is equal to beta, I can substitute in this. For the value of QR, we get minus because of sin 0 is becoming complete 1 0 into sin of beta minus 1.
Thank you.
charge of delta equal to beta in the reactive power term. So we are getting this, Q r is becoming, this charge is becoming 0, Q r is becoming what? Negative. So what the meaning of this one is, yesterday I told already, just remember this one here. Suppose see that, the generator is supplying active and reactive powers, and what is our ultimate goal is actually, this reactive power, this Ps must be, you have to transfer more. Compared to the what?
Qs.
So, if you connect on the load side, if you connect some capacity is connected, like a shunt capacity. So, this Qs, whatever is there, this Qs is actually supplied to the transmission line inductance and as well as the load. Clear? So, if this Qs, if it is actually supplied by the shunt capacitor, this is actually a Qs. Generator has to supply. Instead of generator, if this is actually shunt capacitor, will supply this amount of reactive power of the particular transmission line of Q is supplied, then what the type of reactive power will supply? Lagging or leading?
Lagging.
Capacitor will supply to the
lagging.
Which one?
Lagging.
Lagging what? So it will supply the lagging what is supplied to the line. Line sector. Whenever it is supplying the lagging power to the line, what the capacity will take?
Leading.
Leading power. So, it will actually take the, which one? Leading power seems to be taken. So, on the load end point of view, if this load actually is of capacitive nature, then only it will absorb the, which one?
Leading
power. That is the meaning of this one. QR is negative indicates capacitive nature of load. So that, for this load, which has to be supplied? Leading voltage has to be supplied. Under this condition only, you can able to receive what? Maximum value of active power. The meaning of that one is, reactive power is actually compensated by the capacitor instead of generator. So that you can able to convert complete apparent power in terms of what? Active power. And okay, this condition you have to remove.
Yeah, what is the condition of the
right. Right. Next. Okay, next.